Hi guys, and welcome to the Family Fudge. I'm Jennifer, and today I'm talking about kids and hotels. Now, over the years, I've had plenty of opportunities to stay at hotels with my kids, and I've definitely learned some tips and tricks along the way. So today, I'm very excited to share them with you. So stay tuned. Okay, so kids and hotels. Now, if you're new here, you might not already know this, but I have 4 kids that are 7 and under. So these tips are kind of geared towards younger kids. And unfortunately, you guys, some of these things are on the list because I've learned the hard way that you definitely need them. So hopefully when I share these tips with you today, they will help you on your next hotel stay with kids. Oh yes, and one more thing. If you haven't already, please hit that red subscribe button to come back for future videos. Because on this channel, I like to share all things mommy and family related. I do grocery hauls, organization videos, recipes, lots of recipes, that sort of thing. So if you like those kind of videos, please subscribe. Tip number 1. A lot of times when we get to the hotels, I like to leave my kids in the car with my husband, and I will go into the room and inspect it before I let the kids enter. Because sometimes you just never know what you're gonna find. When I go into the room, I'm checking under beds, I check in the bathroom, I check in cabinets and drawers. I'm just looking for any sort of bugs or anything a previous guest might have left behind that a child shouldn't find. Things like medicine, sharp objects, and I'm also checking for just general cleanliness. I want to make sure that everything looks good before I let my kids in. And here's a tip, you guys. Occasionally, we'll get to a hotel that doesn't feel especially clean. So what I like to do is I'll take my disinfectant wipes, and I might just wipe down the table, or the doorknobs, the remote control, things like that that germs tend to stay on and might get missed by hotel cleaning services. So I definitely check and make sure everything is clean and safe before I let the kids in the room. Tip number 2 is to have a place to corral shoes in the hotel room. That way they're not all over the floor or getting lost. I like to stick a collapsible laundry basket in my suitcase when I travel. That way when I get to the hotel room, I can just pop it up and everyone will put their shoes in this basket when we're in the hotel room. It keeps all of the shoes together, it keeps them from getting lost, and they're not all over the floor and we're not tripping on them. And the best part is that this laundry basket can fold right back up when we're done using it. Tip number 3 is to set up a charging station in your hotel room. When we travel, we like to bring our cameras, our extra batteries, our cell phones, and oftentimes hotel rooms will not have enough plugs for all of these gadgets. I found this charging tower in the dollar section of Target, but you can also find them on Amazon as well, and it gives me the capability of charging 4 gadgets all at once. That way we never run out of battery power. Tip number 4, I like to bring my own soap, both laundry detergent and dish soap as well. Now I actually found both of these at the Dollar Tree, so it was super affordable, much less than if you have to buy them at the hotel. Now, if you're traveling by air, you can actually transfer some of this into these smaller TSA-approved bottles, and then you can still do a couple of loads while you're there. Now, most hotels will have a washer and dryer that you can use, but if you bring your own soap, not only will you save money, but you can have the same soap that you use at home, just in case you have kids with sensitive skin that won't be an issue for them. And then we have the dishwashing soap. I definitely like to bring a small bottle of this so that I can wash my kids' water bottles, baby bottles, things like that. Because stinky baby bottles are no good. Tip number 5 is about dirty clothes. Now, a lot of times when you stay in a hotel, they might provide you with a teeny tiny little plastic bag for your dirty clothes. But if you're a large family with a lot of kids, that teeny tiny plastic bag is not gonna cut it. So what I like to do is to bring my reusable, collapsible, hanging laundry basket. I found this one at Walmart and it works so well. I just hang it up in the closet and every time we have dirty clothes, we just add it in there. It keeps all of the dirty clothes in one place and off the floor. It collapses right back down and goes into my suitcase. And I can reuse it every time we travel. tip number 6 is all about the trash. Now, a lot of times when you stay in a hotel room, they might provide you with a teeny tiny little trash can. But if you're there with your family, that trash can's gonna get filled up really quickly, especially if you have dirty diapers or if you're eating in your room, things like that. So what I like to do is stick a few kitchen garbage bags in my suitcase and bring them along with me. Having these extra garbage bags are so handy in the hotel room, and they're not just for trash. You could also use them for laundry or if you have swimsuits that are wet, anything like that. Now, if you forget to pack your own trash bags from home, what you could do is make sure you hold on to your plastic bags that you might get when you go shopping from the grocery store or Target or wherever you go while you're on your vacation. Hold on to those bags, and then you can use those to keep your trash organized and clean in your hotel room. Tip number 7 helps you baby-proof your room. Now at home, I use outlet covers because I have a 1-year-old who gets all around the house and he's very curious. So yes, I definitely baby-proof our outlets, but you won't necessarily have that in your hotel room. So here's a tip. I like to bring a roll of washi tape. This is paper washi tape. It will not damage your wall or the outlets at all. So I'll just take some of this washi tape and place it over the outlet. The kids can't get in there at all, and it makes it safe. And it cleans up easily. And this little tiny roll doesn't take up a lot of space in your bag. Tip number 8 is all about keeping your hotel room smelling nice. So there might be a lot of reasons why bringing a diffuser might help you. Sometimes when you get to a hotel, it might just smell musty. While other times, if you have a child in diapers, they might stink up the place. Or let's say you're all sharing one hotel room, bathroom that doesn't have an exhaust fan. To combat odor in my hotel room, I like to bring an essential oil diffuser. Now I was actually sent this one to try out, and I have to give it 2 thumbs ups. It works just as well as my more expensive name brand diffuser. Now, just like most diffusers, you just put water and your favorite essential oil in it, but this one's a little bit different because it includes a nightlight that changes color. If I want the room to smell nice and clean, I might diffuse some peppermint oil. If I want all of my kids to calm down and go to bed, I might diffuse some Serenity or Lavender blends. Tip number 9 is all about how your hotel room sounds. Now, a lot of times hotels can be noisy places. Sometimes you might be right next to the elevator. Sometimes you might have some really loud neighbors next door. Now, the last time we stayed in the hotel, right across the street in the park, they were having a jazz festival, like all night long, and it was super loud. So what I like to do is load up my phone with my kids' favorite bedtime music. Then I like to pull out my mini portable speaker. Now I found this one in the dollar section at Target, but you can also find them on Amazon. This helps the music be amplified enough that all of the kids can hear it. And it also helps to drown out the noises outside of our room. Now this is the same soothing music that I play for my kids when we're in the car on a long road trip. Now here's a quick tip. If you don't have mini portable speakers, you can actually use a cup found in your hotel room as an amplifier. You just take your phone, stick it in the cup, and it definitely will make the music sound a little bit louder. Tip number 10 is to bring a nightlight. Nightlights are awesome for several reasons. Now, my kids are still really little and often need to get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom. So having a nightlight helps them find their way. But also, if you have some kids that are unsure, maybe a little scared to stay in a hotel room, you know, it's unfamiliar and they're not sure, bringing a nightlight can definitely help them feel more secure. We really like to bring this cute little one that I have from home. This one was also sent to me to review. You can find it on Amazon. I will link it down below. It is so cute and squishy, and it changes colors. My kids love it. You just plug it in. It actually charges off of a USB cord. This is such a fun nightlight. We love it. Now, if you don't have the space to bring a big nightlight, you could just bring one like this. I found this one at Walmart for just a couple of dollars. Okay, tip number 11 is something that you can do if you're worried your little kids might roll off the bed in the middle of the night. You just go to the bathroom and take one of the towels and then roll it up. take the biggest towel you can find and roll it up. You might need 2 or 3 towels if your towels are small, but you just roll them up just like this. You have a nice long roll. Then go to the bed and peel back the fitted sheet and stick the towels under the sheet and then put the sheet back on the mattress. So this creates a little bumper that hopefully can keep your little kids on the bed and not rolling off in the middle of the night. I have actually done this and it does work. Tip number 12 is to double or triple check your hotel room before your final checkout. What I like to do is load up everything from the room and send my kids and my husband to the car with all of the stuff. And then I will go by myself back into the room and give it the once over. I will check under beds, in cabinets, in drawers, just to make sure that we haven't left anything behind. And occasionally I have found something that had I not double checked, we would have left behind. We would have forgotten it. So I'm always glad when I go back and double or triple check that we have everything. Okay guys, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, can you please give it a big thumbs up? And let me know in the comments down below if you've ever forgotten anything at a hotel. I have a funny story for you guys. When I was about 5 years old, my family and I were traveling and we stayed at a hotel. And I forgot my most prized toy, which was this actual Cabbage Patch doll. Now obviously I got her back and I still have her all these years later. But when we went back to the hotel to pick her up, somebody drew a mustache on her with a pen. I've gotten it off, but I thought that was really rude. So, moral of the story, don't leave stuff at hotel. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.